So, I am outside working on this wall today. This is the before video. And I'm going to take out some of the dirt from here and start building up the wall right there in particular because, well, when I went to court, my neighbor showed the judge a picture of my house directly from his window, so I'm going to mainly work on building up the wall in this specific area. Kind of wondering what the heck happened there, because I didn't do that. Did the neighbor's cats come over here and dig in the ground or what? I don't know. Anyways, and my intent is to literally build up the walls in the physical sense, but also in other ways to keep other forms of magic out, like my neighbor watching me and any other attacks from any enemies that will be coming in the future and that are coming right now. So, like I said, my magical intent is literally to build the walls and to block out my enemies. So I am going to get started and I will update you in a little while. They have helicopters flying over. So it has been a little bit over an hour and I'm actually on the other side of my wall, because I wanted to make it thicker, and you should be able to see exactly how much, yeah, all of this I just added right now. So I am cruising along pretty well. I'm pretty proud of this. But I also need to go and set up a fire tonight to do a little magical ceremony ritual thing. So, I think I am going to take a break on this and go get the fire set up and then come back to this. So, as you can see behind me, I have my fire being built up with leaves and pine needles. But I had some extra trees that are dead laying around that I dug up, and I decided that I wanted to put one on top to watch it burn. So I'm going to nail the tree into the other tree so that it will stay up. Well, I was intending on putting, well, it was a tree. A little messy. Anyways, I was going to put it there and watch it burn, but I only had a rusty nail. Ow! And, well, the nail started bending, and I tried to remove the nail, and that happened. And before that, I hurt myself. So, I think I'm gonna go take a break for a few minutes.
Omni Mater Ergo Logos Inanaya Sophia Aida. Omni Mater Ergo Logos Inanaya Sophia Aika. Omni Mater Ergo Logos Inanaya Sophia Aida. My tree's kind of falling down. I don't even know if you can even see it. So, tonight I am outside. I don't see the moon, but it is supposedly a waning crescent moon. And when the moon is going from full to empty, it is a good time for banishing curses, and what I am here to do is to talk to you about love spells. There are certain ways that you can, you know, tell that you are under a love spell. If you start to take interest in somebody that may not have interested you before, or maybe somebody that you've been friends with for a really long time, and all of a sudden you just start to develop feelings for them. Not saying that they couldn't be true feelings in that situation, but these are just signs. Another sign is that you start to act differently than you were before. Maybe you start to dress differently, or you start to listen to different music, or act differently. Your closest friends will be able to essentially tell you if you are acting, what a beautiful fire, acting differently and that's distracting. Yes, anyways, so I'll leave some links below that you can look at that have different things. I'm getting too distracted by this. So, let us move forward with the spell. And first of all, I created a sigil, which is right here. And I will show you a better view later. But I'm also doing some candle magica, where you write the one person's name on one end of the candle, and you write your name on the other end of the candle, and, well, you light it for 9 minutes, and then you, oh no, make sure that your house doesn't light on fire, because it's pretty long over. Seemed like a good idea at the time. Toasty out here. I can sit close to that. Okay. Where did my candle go? There it is. Okay. Anyways, your name on. Ooh, that's hot. Your name on one end. Wondering if I'm wearing any clothes on underneath this because it's hot right now. I can't really move away from this spot. Okay. So. I'm gonna start this. And I'm also burning. burning off of this. Okay. Going to incorporate. Goodness. It's too hot. Could have been a little bit better prepared for this, but this is live magic, so I can't really know what all will happen. All right. So it's also going to incorporate some binding magicka and basically bind my ankles and bind my wrists and do the 9 minute meditation and basically imagine negativity and all of this love spell nonsense going into these cords as I do it. So let's just get this show on. I'd have to move. Well, this didn't go according to plan, but we'll all live. These cords symbolize all the things that are holding me back from my destiny and doing what I came here to do. And any other spells and curse magicka, I'm going to see all of this energy going into these cords, like I said, and do the 9 minute meditation finally. Okay. To cut these cords from me and throw them into the fire. The only other ropes that I had were my Shibari ropes, and I am not willing to part with those. Okay. So, this spell with the candle spell, it says basically to break the candle in half, separating your two names. And they said to put them into two different trash cans that are going to go separate places, but I'm just going to chop the candle in half and toss it into the fire. So, that will be a big help. And
and my wall magica from earlier is also going to help build my defenses against these sort of attacks. Magicka is all about your intent at the end of the day, so if you are under a love spell or anything like that, you don't have to do any ritual that you find. You can make up your own and just make it a symbolic representation of what you are trying to achieve. So, Omni Mater Ergo Logos Inanaya Sophia Aika. Omni Mater Ergo Logos Inanaya Sophia Aika. Omni Mater Ergo Logos Inanaya Sophia Aika. I just looked down and realized that I did not burn my sigil. So let's make sure. Ooh, hot. Oh! Come on. What is your problem? That's really irritating. Okay. Well, I was planning on lighting one end of the paper and holding it while it burned, but I guess there were other plans in store for that little sigil. So now I can properly close my spell. Omni Mater Ergo Logos Inanaya Sophia Aika. Omni Mater Ergo Logos Inanaya Sophia Aika. Omni Mater Ergo Logos Inanaya Sophia Aika. So yesterday, after I smashed my finger, I was pretty much done with working. And then I had my fire last night, and now I am back out here to work on my wall again. I got a little bit of progress done yesterday over here, and I ended up finding a dead bird over there, so I buried him in the backyard. So, anyways, I am going to get set up here and start to work and hopefully set you somewhere where you can watch me for a little bit. So it has been a little over an hour, and as you can see, this side is pretty much built up all the way to height and a lot wider. So you can see how much wider this one section is from the rest of the wall and all of this dirt down here that I have just removed. So, yay!
Queen, and there's an old man sitting sitting on the throne, never saying that I probably shouldn't be so mean. I'm headed straight for the castle. They've got the kingdom locked up. And there's an old man sitting on the throne, never saying I should probably keep my pretty mouth shut. Headed straight for the castle.